an important discovery from the Kepler space mission, which for the past several years has been looking at staring at the same patch of sky, looking at about 150,000 stars. And it's measuring the brightness of those stars in time to see if there are any planets passing in front of the star. And so if those planets then are at just the right orientation, they can block some of the light, and Kepler can measure that at unprecedented levels. And so this discovery is about a particular planetary system, which goes under the name Kepler 186, which means it's the 186th discovery of Kepler, where that planetary system has been verified beyond a reasonable doubt. There is no other interpretation except that these are definitely planets passing in front of the star. And so Kepler 186 is special because there are actually five of them all orbiting the same star, and they are all very small planets comparable in size to the Earth. And so one of them is in the habitable zone. Okay, so this region that is just the right separation from the star, in which it is not too hot and not too cold. And so if there is liquid water, or if there is water, it would be in a liquid phase. And so the planet is 1.1 times the radius of the Earth. And so just a little bit more surface area, a little bit larger size than the Earth itself, and it's right smack dab in the habitable zone. And so what's also interesting about this discovery is the star itself is what we call an M star. It's a very small star that that is fainter and gives off less light. And so the habitable zone around this star is much closer. And so Kepler was able to detect this planet and the other four planets in a system that are a little bit too close to the star. They're too warm. But these M stars, they basically burn hydrogen forever. They live essentially forever. And so if you place down a planet in the habitable zone around an M star and the orbit is stable, which it is in this case, then it can last for a very long time, billions of years, and that gives life the opportunity to develop. It gives you a substantial a chance. The chances for life to develop are increased significantly if the planet can remain in that temperate region for a very long time. Kepler is rewriting textbooks. It is telling us the statistics of planets. How common are our solar systems? Are there other solar system analogs out there? Are there other planets that resemble the Earth? Basically, the galaxy is teeming with planets, but ironically, we haven't found them close enough to our sun or close enough to the Earth yet to be able to characterize their atmospheres. And so we are building a new instrument for the Large Binocular Telescope, which we will test here on this, first on this small 0.8 meter telescope, the Chrismonic Telescope at Notre Dame, which will actually be able to probe the atmospheres of the planets to tell us what they are made out of. What is their chemical composition? Do they have biosignatures? Is there the potential for life to develop on these very nearby worlds, which we know must exist?